Gospel of August the 18, 2014, a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. A young man approached Jesus and said, "Teacher, what good must I do to gain eternal life?" He answered him, "Why do you ask me about the good? There is only one who is good. But if you wish to enter into life, keep the commandments." He asked him, "Which ones?" And Jesus replied, "You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. Honor your father and your mother, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself." The young man said to him, "All of these I have observed. What do I still lack?" Jesus said to him, "If you wish to be perfect, go sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me." When the young man heard this statement, he went away sad, for he had many possessions. Gospel of the Lord, praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We have this beautiful fragment of the Gospel, very well known, yet I believe little deepened. God, who created each and every one of us, planted in us intelligence and reasoning, and He expects us to put that to work when we try to ruminate His words, when we ponder every word and every scene of the Gospel, trying to get to know Him. It is very interesting, the scene. This young rich man approached Jesus and asks, "Teacher, what good must I do to gain eternal life?" He does not recognize him as Lord, only as a teacher. Yet, immediately the Lord starts asking him, questioning him, who, or rather from who, that eternal life comes. Of course, it comes from God. And that's why he says, "Why did you ask me about good? There is only one who is good, and that is God. Why did you ask me? If you do not recognize me as Lord, but only as a teacher, you have to set your eyes higher to encounter me, to really find out who I am." But then he lowers himself, the Lord lowers himself to answer him humanly. "Keep the commandments." The young man asks, "Which ones?" And the Lord replies with only six. The Lord's reply encompasses from Exodus to Leviticus to Deuteronomy. Yet, if you read them carefully, "You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal, nor bear false witness. Honor your father and your mother. Love your neighbor as yourself." There are only six. The number six also calls for our human limitness. But the most important one, the one in chapter 6 of Deuteronomy, is not there. Further on the same Gospel of Matthew, a scribe asked the Lord, "Which is the greatest command of all?" And the Lord immediately cites chapter 6. "Shema Yisrael, Yahweh Elohenu, Yahweh Echad, ve'ahavta l'elokecha bechol levavecha, uvchol nefshecha, uvchol me'odecha." Which translated means, "Hear, O Israel, Yahweh our God is one, and you should love your God with all your conscience, with all your life, and all your strength." This is the first one, and it's exactly the one that is missing on the list that the Lord just explained to this rich man. Immediately the young rich man answers, "All of this I have observed. Why do I still lack?" Now it becomes very evident. It shouts to be noted that the first one and the most important, the basis for everyone, is missing: the love of God. Now the Lord will show him that he is missing the greatest and most basic of all commandments. If you wish to be perfect, go and sell what you have and give the poor. Then come back and follow me. And then, once this young man is confronted with that situation, he has to realize, I don't know if he did realize, but we can realize, that his true God were money. The money was his true God, his true idol, because he worshipped the money and his possessions more than he could worship God. Now, could it happen to you or me? It is very easy to try to do as much things, to try to comply with the law. Well, I don't kill. Well, I don't steal. I don't commit adultery. I don't bear false testimony. I try to honor my father. I try to be good with my neighbor. But then there are these philanthropists who think that they are very good, and that because they are good, they do all of this. They do good deeds, indeed, but they don't do it. They might be even atheists. Now, there is a great difference. In one of the Gospels, the Lord says, if one should welcome a prophet because he is a prophet, he will receive a prophet's reward. If one should welcome a just man because he is a just man, he will receive a just man's reward. That is, whatever either the prophet or the good man can give to that person who is welcoming. But then he says, whoever receives one of these, and he is talking about his apostles, because he is mine, will not lose his reward in heaven. So you see, we have to be moved by the true love of God. All our acts have to be lightened by that love. Caritas Christi urget nos, which means the love of Christ urges us to love all our brothers. Once the young rich man is confronted with that, he goes away. He would rather keep his money, his possessions, than go to God. The late Saint John Paul II, late Pope, used to say, do not have fear. Open, wide open the door to Christ, because he does not take away anything and he gives you everything. And it is true. Do not be afraid, because the Lord will not take away from you anything. It is just also, as John Duns Scotus would say, we have to love in harmony. First, love God above everything, and then know, fully know, that everything we have, from the material, the money that we might have, from health and our own self, intelligence, wit, everything is a gift from God. And there is no gift or sum of gifts that will be equal to the giver of gifts, that is our Lord. May the Lord increase our faith and our love in each one of our hearts. God bless you all, brothers.